What is going on, everybody, and welcome back once again. My name is Jordan, also known as Jay Monster, and you're watching another episode of our Azurai campaign. We are coming down to the close here. We have a couple turns left before the Oak of Ages is in full blossom, and that means that we can take the fight to the corruptor, Morghur the Shadowgave, and drive him from our world once and for all, thereby saving the forest. We have two armies here long prepared. Dirthu, the embodiment of the anger that the forest feels at the corruption that the Shadowgave brings with him, and his foul children, the Beastmen, as well. He's also got a army here backed up by another woodland ancient, Iskura, who's here to do his part to ensure that the Shadowgave has been completely destroyed. Before we get into it and pass the next couple turns, which I'm sure are going to go by very quickly, I want to let you guys know that I do now have a Twitter and a Facebook account, so if you guys are interested in following along with what's going on with the channel, that's a great place to do it. And I'm going to start putting them in all of our videos from now on, so you'll have easy access to them at any point that you want it. But with that being said, let's pass the turn and let's get into this. It looks like the Beastmen here are corrupting the forest with their very presence. None of them are really able to fight us. Ooh, Paravine wants to be buddy-buddy. That's fine with me. A couple more amber for the cause. We have one final turn. Go down here and we're going to check out the Oak of Ages. A small force there under Thilvokas, mostly as auxiliaries to help out with the defense of the tree. We are going to spend... We should get one more unit, I think, of Eternal Garb Shields, and that'll be it. I'm pretty sure the Oak of Ages is now defended from just about anything. Let's see here. Might as well do something with these. We'll get some extra Winds of Magic power. Ooh, nope. No, we'll be fine. Okay, so we have enough Amber to do that. Perfect. And we're going to pass turn, and then it should be time to take the fight to Morghur and destroy him. Sure, man, whatever you want. Go to hell.
You are imbued with the Oak's power now, Dirthu. The forest is your strength. Such a power can destroy Morghur once and for all. Go now, march to him, stop his plans, destroy him forever.
This is it, guys. This is the final battle between us and Morghur. We've got extra magic. We have everything we could possibly need. Vengeance of the Azurai, that is a very, very appropriate event to happen right now. Looks like we're not actually going to be able to use Iskura in the battle. We're going to have to fight it out with our Wood Elven allies here with some preset armies. And Dirthu's very, very elite, very storied army here. So we've got a lot of spearmen, a lot of archers, and some treekin to help us hold the front lines. Alright, I'll see you guys on the battlefield for this final climactic ending.
The Oak of Ages stands strong in the face of adversity. You have the strength to stop Morghur. Let the Horn of Kurnus blast one last time in triumph and rid the world of these foul creatures forever.
Alright, it's time. We're going to balance out our deployment. We're going to put three units of our Eternal Guard on each side to hold the line.
Children of Athel Loren!
And backing them up is going to be one unit of Treekin each. I'm going to stick our Lifesinger in the center so that she's able to support our troops. A couple units of Glade Guard in the center. I'm going to deploy these guys here in an ambush position so they can start taking some shots at Morghur and his elite guard, if you can call the chaos spawn that, as soon as they get onto the map. Hold these guys in reserve. Dirthu himself. I'm going to stick him right over here, and we're going to move a couple units of our Glade Guard over here as well to get them in this, make just this little area right here just one big killing zone. Let's see what have we got here, and I guess we will do the same with these troops. You guys can be group one, two. Alright, let's do this. It has all led to this moment. Line it up, line it up, line it up. Morghur's dark aura protects him from damage, so we're going to have to DPS him essentially in bursts. So let's move our Eternal Guard forward.
Moving orders!
Oh, you gonna let me deploy them there? Okay, there we go.
Quickly!
Armed and ready!
Move you guys to the front. Keep a unit here in reserve for when the front line begins to wear down. We won't have quite so easy of a time of it over here. We're actually going to have to deploy them all. We will hold... No. Put these guys right here because this is where it's going to be hardest. This is going to be the most important place to hold. Come on.
We never miss.
Come on, guys. Do it. Get them up here on this hill. It's a good place for them to be. See, how are our allies doing? They've got a lot of forces back there, and looks like some harpies. Harpies. They've added the new DLC unit to this battle. Oh yeah. It's gonna go down, guys. Morghur's aura is at full strength again. I had no chance to hit him anyway. These beastmen bringing up the rear. I think they're just gonna keep spawning. Some Bestigors right there. Very tough.
Bows of Athel Loren.
Let's rain death and destruction down upon these guys. Oh, that's gonna start. I have a way to fix that if we do any further Wood Elven campaigns, because for whatever reason it just seems to be the Wood Elves that's a problem with. If that becomes an issue in any of our other campaigns, I will just do replays of the battles and do them at half speed and then speed it up in post-production, so you won't really notice the difference. It's the best! It's the smartest option, I think. We got here another unit of Glade Guard. Honestly, you guys would do better if you were right here. And you as well. You guys seem to be hitting a lot of the trees and not doing your job. So let's move these guys over here, balance it out a little bit. Puts these guys behind our front line on the left flank. Ooh, come on, Durthu. Do it, boy. Hey, what are you doing? No, you need to be there. Oh no, what's going on? Look at this. We will destroy these Beastmen scum once and for all. Pop down an Earthblood here. Keep our troops as healthy as possible. We've still got some Treekin in reserve to fill up any gaps that might open in our line. Look at this. It's just taking so much damage as they come in. I wonder if we can get away with this. Oh yeah, we can. Die, Beastmen scum! Oh, you know, I think it has something to do with the arrows. For whatever reason, the arrows cause a lot of issues with my computer. Where the hell is Morghur? Aha! Archers! Target the Corruptor! Now's the time. Deal as much damage to him as possible while we have the opportunity. Oh man, it's getting real on that side. So they're managing to scoot some war dogs through. I think we might actually need Durthu on this side to combat Morghur himself. It's probably the best thing we can do. We're actually going to have him move post haste as Aura is at full strength again. We're wasting our time. Let's kill those damn dogs. Slow down just a bit. Let's take a look at how our allies are doing. It is looking grim. Looking very grim. We may find ourselves getting flanked here. We got over here. Looks like a unit of... Oh my god, it's a Saigor! I have nothing to throw at him. I have nothing that I can do to him right now. It looks like we're going to need our tree kid over here on the right flank more than anywhere else. Attack, brothers! Maybe it's better if we move all of these archers over this way so there's no trees between them and Morghur. We can just do all of the damage to him that we want. Yeah, we've opened up a gap in our line here. Doesn't seem like the Beastmen are doing a whole lot on this side. So we are actually going to pull some of our troops back here. Maybe we can pull back these guys to help give our allies a bit of a boost. Because it seems that they need it quite a lot. So we're going to move our reserves back there. Kill them all! We're gonna speed it up just a tad. Where's Morghur? He's barely taking any damage, that bastard. Yeah, our troops there are really struggling. We need to get Morghur's aura will be weakened. Hold on. Let's slow down just for a second here and try and find that little rat bastard. Spawn of the Shadowgave. I don't know where he's hiding. I want to get him, though. Oh, no. There he is. Morghur the Shadowgave. On him, Durthu. All of our archers need to focus on him right now. Where is he? Where did he go? Oh no, I've lost him again. Curse you! Curse you, deceiver. Oh no, oh well, we've lost him, that's fine. Let's speed it up just a bit. Durthu knows where he is though, and that's all that matters. Aha! I see him in there. Durthu's not gonna play around. Alright, it's time that we drop a nice bomb heal right in this area. Follow it up with an earth blood, because this is where all of the beastmen seem to be funneling into. Ah, man, we've got to drive these monsters back. We need to keep Durthu on Morghur at all times, because he's gonna be our main DPS. Let's have everybody here fire into the flank and rear of his beastmen hordes, thin them out. There's just more and more of them pouring in here. Let's take a look at how things are going over in this direction. So far, our allies are holding the line, but they are being driven back on the left. Looks like they've got another Saigor in the back there. There's not really a whole lot we can do about it, unfortunately. We need to focus on Morghur. Oh, he's coming up. Our opportunity is going to be here in just a moment. Where is that shifty bastard? Morghur the Shadowgave. There he is. Come on, Durthu. There's the Shadowgave. We need to stop him. Come on, boys, fire at him. It's hard to find him without the banners. I should probably turn those back on. There we are. Well, fire at these guys. They're in the area. That's good enough for me. Durthu's just kind of standing there, just doing his own thing. We are slowly whittling down the Shadowgave. But unfortunately, it is taking a very, very long time, and there are quite a lot of beastmen here. I don't know if they're ever going to stop. They might not. We might be doomed. Looks like our Way Watchers here are stuck in melee. That's kind of okay, because we need something to be there. Oh no, we're taking damage from that Saigor. Let's have to throw these guys into the front lines here. Take those Bestigors head on. Let's fast forward it just a tad. Start slaughtering some more of these beastmen. They're really starting to pile up here. Our archers don't seem to be firing. Oh no, they're just taking their time at doing it. Let's see how this is gonna work. Nope, not very well at all. That's unfortunate. There's a lot of half health, low morale beastmen units. Durthu still in the fray, still doing work. Where's that damned Shadowgave? And he's taking a lot of damage. Come on, Durthu. Let's get in there and hurt the Shadowgave just a little bit more. He's now very tired. Fast forward just a tad. Morghur's aura is going to be coming down shortly. Come on, guys. Do it. If we can rout him, too. If we can break his morale, I think that also counts. Aw, he just took damage from Durthu. A lot of damage, in fact. Archers, fire at will. Need to kill Morghur. He's taking a lot of damage from Durthu. Come on, Durthu. Do it! Hold the line, damn it! How's she doing here? Time to pop down another big heal. Doing work. We missed our. We dropped that other spell just a little bit too early. Where's the Shadowgave? Come on, kill his ass. We still have an opportunity. He's down to half health. Decent amount of DPS. Decent that time. I'm gonna give these Eternal Guard a little bit of help here. They really desperately need it. Time to drop the Sword of Dieth. Sword of Daith. That's the one. That's what it is. I remember now. It's best to our herd here. Looks like we've managed to surround them with a lot of our archers and other infantry. They're slowly being whittled down, but we're going to take a charge in the rear from these Ungors, which really makes me very unhappy. Makes me a sad panda indeed. Looks like we've got some incoming troops here. These guys aren't doing too much right now, so we're going to turn them around. See if we can't destroy these harpies. They're very, very weak to missiles, so we should be able to see them off very quickly, very handily. So far, our troops here are doing a wonderful job. Now might be the time to move these guys forward. We're actually going to get some more treekin into the back because they are very sturdy and they can just soak up a lot of damage. So if they get flanked from incoming troops from this direction, it's not going to be such a big deal because they're always going to be outnumbered and always surrounded. So, Morghur's protective aura is up. I didn't even notice. Where is that bastard? Let's slow it down. Oh, the damned Shadowgave. Let's drop this on top of him. See how he likes it. Come on. Boom. Nice big chunk out of his health right there. Take that. Drop another heal here. We're getting pretty low on Winds of Magic. Might be time to start drawing upon our reserves. Still got 30 reserve power. That's quite a lot. Let's do that. Let's get some more Winds of Magic right now. One power every 5 seconds. That's pretty damn good. Speed it up just a tad. Looks like our allies here starting to fail. Move some of our archers back. Destroy more of these Beastmen. It looks like they are managing to hold back the tide. I don't see any more additional Beastmen coming in. Oh, thank God. I thought we were going to have to deal with another and never-ending force right in our rear. We got some Waywatchers here having a lot of trouble. Let's pull back one of our units of Eternal Guard here to deal with these Chaos Spawn. Oh, the enemy units are starting to break. Just the mere presence of our Treekin in the rear was enough to do that. Morghur's Protective Aura is weakened again. Come on, now is the time. Where is the damn Shadowgave? Let's get him. Everybody on Morghur. Now! He needs to die. Come on, Durthu. Come on. Oh, it's so hard to get any decent damage in there. Oh, another slice coming off of his health. We just need one more hit. One more hit. This might be enough to bring down the Shadowgave right now. Oh, no. We're going to have to wait until the next cycle. Our Eternal Guard here, exhausted, but holding the line. Thankfully, we have a lot of support coming in from our very experienced Lifesinger. Save. Now the Corruptor's nothing but shadows. Looks like he's routing. We have done it. Oh, this is fantastic. There we go. The Beastmen are no more. Look at them run. Fleeing in the face of Azrai supremacy. There's no escape for these creatures. There can be no redemption. We are going to run them down. We're going to chase them off the map. Look at these hordes. They're fleeing in the face of the Azrai. Let's take a look at it down here. Oh, that's kind of annoying. Look at this. So many Wood Elves gave their lives over here to buy us the time we needed to take down the Corruptor. Wonder if we could find his body. Where is it? There's no way. No, it's just in a big bloody mess of troops. We actually did pretty well. Our Eternal Guard held the line admirably against the never-ending hordes of Beastmen. Now it's time to drive these guys from the field. Speed it up a whole bunch. Charge, brothers! This is where I wish I had some cavalry. Would have been really useful. But I figured I was going to be able to use Iskura and his army in order to do that. Oh, we've still got some chaos spawn here. That's what's holding up the show. All right, let's finish these guys off. Death to the spawn, unclean ones. Oh, they really holding on. I'm actually really impressed by this. Come on, just die already. Got some Eternal Guard in there. Beastmen hordes are now officially gone, fleeing back to their forests and huts in Drakwald. Oh, got some more chaos spawn over here. Surround them. Oh no, they're giving those poor Sisters of the Thorn a real issue. I've never used the Sisters of the Thorn. I don't even know what they do. I think they're like spellcasters, but also Javcav. Come on, Chaos Spawn, just die already. There it is. Victory is ours. Well, everybody, this is really exciting. I think this is one of our first officially finished campaigns where we've had no, like, problems with a computer or something that has obliterated my save games. So we've done it. We have completed the Azrai campaign on hard, and it is one of our first campaigns. It is a fantastic accomplishment. I feel so good right now. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the post-battle screen. A decisive victory. So many beastmen deployed, thousands of them dead. We lost quite a number of our Azrai brothers in return.
I won this enchant.
Does rage still beat in your heart, Durthul? Even now, with Morghur consigned to oblivion and the world returned from the brink, does war still drive your mind? Your dreams are disturbed by voices that speak of your failures. But mark this amongst your successes. There can be no greater victory. You were roused from slumber to achieve this, to defeat the evil that threatened the Deep Wood. Perhaps now you can rest again. Your sorrow is boundless and anger all-consuming. Sleep now in the forest's arms, ancient Durthul. Let fitful and restless sleep torment you until you are woken again.
There it is. Pretty good. Region's own 7. Not bad. We have one of the largest empires. It's a lot of events. So much stuff happened. Statistics. Let's take a look at that. Current settlements held 5. Current turn 111. That's probably one of my faster campaigns. 43 buildings constructed. That's a lot of money. I wonder if it can. Wonder if it will show us just how many people we've killed. Units recruited. Units destroyed. 204. That's quite a lot. We did not lose a single unit. That is interesting. That is very impressive. Total victories. Losses, 0. Wow, it's pretty easy. I mean, despite it being on hard, I thought it was going to be a lot more difficult than what it was. Aftermaths. 3 heroes recruited. One for every army, and one wayward waywatcher who just got brought in at the end and had nothing to do. Alright, there you go, guys. That is the Seasons of Revelations campaign. That is it from start to finish. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It's been a long and bumpy ride, and I will see you in... Actually, we're going to have a Total War replay coming up next. We're going to have another 3 versus 3 on Total War Reforged. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you then. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye!